Yeah. Trump is innocent. Firmly believe that. And I've never seen such a useless president. And, like, I recently also watched a... Something's going on with my mic. Hang on a second, folks. I do not know what's going on. Yes, so I'm just going to turn that off. Okay. So the point is that we actually need to understand what is going on with this so-calledly U-Butte president. And unfortunately, I don't think he is a U-Butte president. I think he's a bumbling idiot. And I actually believe that he is being controlled, and there is evidence out there of that. You've just got to put the evidence together. Now, they're talking about one, Michelle Obama, may be the next forerunner for the Democrats. Now, very fact that it's very strange that Obama was the only president that never ever left Washington after his term. Now, why is that? Because this has all been planned, right? They know that they can't beat Trump. So what have they done to Trump? They've been railroading him through this, through Fannie Willis and everything. And the whole thing is, it's sort of, you can go through, you can look at it, you can look at all the different things that the liars, and and I say liars, like, I'll tell you now, I can tell a liar a mile away. See, salesmen, I used to be a salesman, and one of the things that you have to do when you're a salesman is lie, but I refused to do that when I was a salesman. I always used to tell the truth. I actually got more sales out of it because I did tell the truth about it. But I actually watched all the other salesmen and all the lies they used to tell. And they have a certain look. And he's got that look. Whoops, no, we need her. Where is she? She's got that look. So like the, oh, I'm innocent, I didn't do nothing wrong. And then there's the little smiles and the different smirks that you see throughout. Now, I'm not going to play you the footage of this and everything, because she's up to old tricks again in the hearing, but then you go through and you find things like this. This is Professor Nez. Now, I'm actually going to play a little bit of the video and then I'm going to react to it. So yeah, it's my first reaction video, guys, but this needs to be said. And this, see, I've got to admit it, I'm part black, I'm part Aboriginal. My father was part Aboriginal, my grandmother was a quarter caste Aboriginal, my grandfather was half caste Aboriginal, and his dad was full blood. So yeah, I'm Aboriginal. I got nothing against black people, so understand that.
Say this right now, check this out.
If you had to give me a sentence, what is the sentence being?
Once I told him about his, respectfully, and in an email about his lack of leadership and the fact that he wanted to do things with grants that were impossible, and I...
Now, that's all of that. This is a lady complaining about somebody else. She was fired because she complained to Fannie Willis. Where is she? This is recently being found. So you can look at this. I'll get the links of these videos and I'll put them in the description of this video when I upload it, so that you can actually go and watch these videos for yourself. And so you can put that same evidence together in your own mind. And you will see that, number one, Trump is being railroaded, not by just Joe Biden, but one certain man. And why do I say this? Because the evidence is there. The evidence is actually there. So, like, this is the one who's really running it is Barack Obama, because of this sort of thing.
Enter.
In the coming days, we're going to join with our friends in Jordan and others some Friday airdrops of of additional food and supplies into Ukraine.
Into Ukraine? And Mildred, he's making up countries again. God, anyway.
So, as you can see there, he makes gaffe after gaffe after gaffe after gaffe and everything. And, like, I watched that Trump speech when the insurrection happened. Well, wasn't really an insurrection when a Democrat opens the doors for them. Yeah, it was set up. And trust me, the evidence is there. All Americans need to force this government to release all January 6 footage. All of it. Because if you only go through what has been released, you will actually see it yourself. Most of them were led through by the police and everything, and yet they were jailed, and they were led by the police. So something is going on. And they say power corrupts, and it's really true. Power does corrupt, big time. But when you've got a president like Trump, who doesn't need the money, you've actually got a decent man in there. And like, I've watched Trump's career for many, many years. And I was amazed at watching how this man had turned a little bit that he got from his dad into a mega fortune. And I mean a mega fortune. Yes, Trump is one of the wealthiest men in the world. One of. And I wouldn't say the wealthiest, especially after now. He's been railroaded and railroaded through case after case. I've never seen so many attempts to put a man in a courtroom to keep him away from election campaigning. And that's the thing. It's sort of, this is what it's really about. They know they cannot defeat Trump. So what do? They set him up. And this is nothing more than a setup. All because you've got a bumbling idiot out there. And like, I've met many people, and like, then you've got this woman who is the biggest liar that I've ever seen in my life. The eyes give it away. See, the Bible even tells you that the eyes are the windows to the soul. And it's very, very true. The eyes are really the window to the soul. Look at the eyes in these people. But see, that's not the catch. And then we jump back to where I said, it's really Obama running everything, right? They knew that they couldn't get anybody else. He couldn't run in again. And he's been trying to talk his wife into running, right, for a long while. And she said she doesn't want to do it. But 10-1, she's in on it. All the Democrats are in on it. See, they thought the setting up a bumbling Joe Biden and an even worse Kamala Harris. God almighty. See, that's why they knew the Democrats wouldn't swap Biden for her, and then they can control Joe. But I even think Hunter's got something to do with this as well. I really do. See, I think Obama personally is leading Hunter. Hunter's influencing his dad, trying to keep his ass out of jail. And by the way, Hunter, yeah, you should be in jail, mate. And it's sort of, you do the crime, you do the time. I screwed up when I was young, but I admitted it. I didn't deny it when I went to court. I was lucky it was juvenile. And yeah, but I still did the time. Oh, I didn't go to jail. Oh, sorry, I did go to jail for 7 days. But the thing, that was over a traffic fine. But the thing is, it sort of, when it came to the other, got my bond, served out my time, and lived a very honest life ever since. And I've done well with myself, but I've always been honest with every employer that I have ever had and told them the truth, that I screwed up when I was young. And if you've done it when you're young, don't be afraid to tell your employer, because the thing is, employers understand. As an employer myself, I understand if someone came to me and said, yes, okay, I screwed up when I was young, but I've been okay ever since. Yes, I might throw a little test into their honesty every now and then, but the thing is, it's sort of, you've got to be careful what you do. But this woman is just basically a thing. That the thing is, why are they using black judges, sorry, not black judges, black DAs, black governors, attorney generals, sorry. They've got a black spokesman because they're trying to appeal to the black community. And then when Fanny goes into the church and then corrupts all chances of getting a fair jury for Trump, and I can tell you now, that's what it was meant to do. That little church visit was meant so that Trump couldn't get a jury on his side. They made it so that it was impossible in that town for Trump to get a fair trial. And everything is all around the black vote. And yet they've proved that Biden's the one that's being the racist the whole time. Everybody, when they've done, like street YouTubers like myself, well, I'm not a street YouTuber, but there's a lot of street YouTubers out there that have been going around and asking people what they think of Trump's speech when it's racist. And then they find out it was actually Joe Biden. So go and watch those videos. They're out there. They really, truly are out there. And you will start to realize that something big is going on. This is most probably the biggest fraud that has ever, ever being committed, and I mean ever, and it's being committed by the Democratic Party and the whole lot of the top shelf. And like, this goes all the way to the top, it really does. When it involves an ex-president, sorry, not Trump, involves Obama. Why do I say Barack Obama? Right, you've only got to watch these. Now, these I will play the entirety, right? These are public news. I can play the whole thing without fear.
Thank you, Vice President Biden. Vice President. That wasn't...
See, that statement alone says that it may have been put off as a joke, but in effect, he's not really the president. Barack Obama is really the president, and that proof's going to come up in a minute. Right, one thing, even when Obama was in there, I thought, mate, dishonest. But the thing is, I would love to see a black president come up that was 100% honest. 100% honest. But the only honest president I've ever seen so far is Trump. Done everything he said he would do. Everything. This is why they're scared of him, because they know he will do something. And yeah, but just continue to watch. I'm going to shut up for a little while.
That was all set up.
So look at the smirk on his face. Look at the eyes. He's the one really in charge, and he knows it. He knows it. He knows he's still in charge. And that's who's really running the country, is Barack Obama. See, he can't be president again. He tried, and yeah, he wanted to be, but yeah, he found out he couldn't, because it's 8 years. So... So they're trying to make out to Joe. See, unfortunately with dementia now, I do have to talk about dementia here. Why am I talking about dementia? Mainly to the fact that dementia is something that you wouldn't want for your family. Unfortunately, I've gone through it with mine. My grandmother even convinced me that she was okay. She used to tell me, oh, it's all a joke. It's just so I can get them to do stuff. But she knew. And eventually I did work it out, because there were times that I started asking her questions and then realised, okay, it's not a joke. She actually really did have dementia. It's actually one of the reasons I study every year, so I can fight dementia. And by the way, if you've got dementia in your family, start studying, because doctors will tell you, studying actually builds brain cells. It actually has been proven to fought off dementia. Maybe that's what Joe should have done, is learn stuff new instead of listening to everybody and letting them control him like a puppet, because that's all he is. Joe Biden is nothing more than a puppet. We've seen his gaffes, we've seen his falls, and they are 100% everything of a dementia patient. They really, truly are. I've spoken to my doctor friends and everything like that, and they've said, yeah, he's got dementia. It's so easy to see. And he should be forced to take a test. And I really think he should be. If this man runs again, he should be forced to take a mental acuity test by many doctors, not just by one, by many. And I believe this is the first time a president is forced to actually take these mental tests. And it should be. We're looking at what he's doing and everything. Even the Italians are making fun of this man. So I'm going to get back to it for a sec. I'm going to turn that music off until... Right, but the thing is, it's sort of, you look at everything and you look at the smiles. He knows that he is in charge. The way he ignores Biden and looking at how, again, how he gushes over Obama. And look at him. He's being ignored. Everybody's going to Biden, not Biden, into Obama. Because they know Obama's really running the country, because they're the ones that helped set it up. They could not have done it if the leaders of the Democratic Party weren't in on this. That's the thing. This goes all the way to the top. Goes all the way to a former president. See, he shrugs off Obama. I'm sorry, Biden. Obama shrugs him off here. And he's trying to get Obama's attention. And yet, this is the man that... See what I mean? Look at his face. He knows. He's trying to talk to Biden. This is the president, for God's sake. So-called. There's the real president there. Obama. Obama is... See how... Yeah. is right behind him. Joe's trying to get Obama's attention, and he's being ignored. And yet, he is the damn president. He's not the president. There's the real president there. Barack Obama. And he knows it. And yeah, it's why Joe's giving him the pen. And see, Nancy Pelosi's in on it. They're all in on it. This is how they set Trump up. They set Trump up. They think they've got away with it. But I tell you now, investigations should go into Pelosi, should go into Obama, should go to every leading Democrat that helped set this up. Because look at him. This is a man with dementia. A president wouldn't be doing that. There's the president right there in the back, smiles, doing exactly what a president does. Not because he's done it, because he's still in charge. And the only way that could happen is if all those people there were in on it. Every single one of them needs to be investigated. And I'll tell you now, if this happened in Australia, we would have picked it up in a bloody heartbeat. And that's the thing. These people are the only way that that man can still run the country, because they know Bumbling Joe can't do it. They know that Bumbling Joe has no hope of beating. And yes, I believe the same as Trump, that it was set up. And yeah. Now, again, more pictures. Sorry, more pictures of... I think this is the one with sound. I'm just going to turn it down a little bit. So you can see... Oh, there's music in the background. Sorry, it's going off. So here you can see he's wandering around. Then they're not paying attention to the president. This is who should be the one they're paying attention to. He can't even get the attention of the thing. As far as Barack Obama is concerned... Joe is nothing but a puppet, so he's ignoring the shit out of him. He's still the president. See, they know. Look at the Secret Service. They're not protecting Joe. They're protecting Barack. Everything, you look at the way the Secret Service are acting. They're looking after Barack Obama, right? Joe is getting no joy out of it. Some of the guards in there, I think, know what the hell is going on. And that's the thing. It's wrong, folks. It really, truly is wrong. But this is where the... No, wrong one. This is where the... Is that the party? No. Or was that the same one? Oh, yeah, that was the one. I think we already played it. So, that's the thing, folks. It should be brought to everybody's attention that this is the man that's really running your country. The proof is in these videos themselves, and there's more on this. There was a White House function. I couldn't find that video where same thing happened. Barrack was the one that got all the attention. Joe didn't get any. He's so-called the president. No, he's not. There's your president there. That's who's really running your country. He couldn't get in as a parliament. She knows about it. Look at a smile on her face. She should be standing next to the president, not the former president. And this is what you have to believe, because if you don't, your country's screwed. At the moment, it is screwed. And you need to start realising this. Yes. The fact that what he did to the border, see, why they did that, why they let the border open, see, they're trying to get more people in to vote for Joe. Because these people most probably got told, you vote for Joe, we're going to give you the vote, you vote for Joe, you get to stay. Yeah, think about it, folks. Got some bad news for you anyhow. The big fella's back. Right, the one upstairs, the big fella is back. Seen the proof myself. And he's even got a channel on YouTube. You want to go and look at it. It's one. It's in my subscriptions. I sub to him. And so they're all going to get a big shock soon. Very big shock. But the thing is, folks, what you need to realise is that you need an honest president. You really do. Trump is the man. Trump has been railroaded. Think about how many cases have been formed against this man. Right? He has virtually cost him nearly all his money. He can't operate in New York, and he can't do anything. Can't run his own business. If he sells it to pay everybody off, he can never buy it back. So this is what I mean. You've only got to look at the number of cases. This is electoral interference, 100%. 100%. If this happened in our country, they would have been put down like dogs and kicked out and put in jail. And at least we're a bit wiser in regard to shit like that. We've lost a prime minister in the past. It was pulled off many years ago, and then our country got a bit smart about it and started realising that shit can really happen. So there's certain things that sort of protect everybody now. But the thing is, it's sort of, this can only come from the top, not from Joe, from him. They're using black voters, they're using black attorney generals, they're using black DAs, and I want to know how many of these other counties where they are things, but nearly every one of these court cases against Trump has been filed by a Democrat. This is electoral interference. It's nothing else, folks. And if you don't wake up to it, you're in a great deal of trouble. As I said, I'm part black myself, and I don't agree what these arseholes are doing. And that's what they are. They're arseholes. God almighty. If I was asked to run for president in that country, you know what I'd say? No fucking way. Because it's the most corrupt system that the Democrats have set up. They use the pandemic. And trust me, we all know that the pandemic was a setup. Right? It actually started in 2019. They lied about that. Right? There's proof if you go to Event 201. Right, there's a website for it, Event 201. Then you go into the documents And then it says, got model for event 201. Right at the beginning of it, there's a statement that proves this started in 2019. We've done a video on it before. And this was all caused for one thing and one thing only, so that they could use this to rig the election. Right? Postal votes. Think about it. How easy is it if you're running the country or you've got a high position or you know people in this? And we're seeing the corruption with DAs and governors, attorney generals. But they're now making it hard. And the speech that he gave to the Supreme Court judges, mate, that was a joke. They're virtually threatening the Supreme Court justices to be careful. Think about it. There's something wrong in the state of the United States. Something very, very wrong over there, guys, and it's massive. You need to do something about it. And if you vote for anybody else but Trump, you're going to screw yourselves. Think about it. Think about what Joe Biden has done over the last 4 years. He said, oh, well, I'm one of the best presidents there is, and compared himself to other presidents in the State of the Union. You can see even some Democrats shaking their heads. They know that he's full of shit. They know that that man on the screen right now is truly running the country. They know that. Biden's done nothing for your country. And if you are black and you listen to that Democratic Party say, oh, well, if you're not black, if you don't vote for Biden, you're not black. That's bullshit. If you're black, you definitely should vote for Trump. Why? Because he's done more for your kind over there. And I'm saying because I'm a different black race. I'm Australian Aboriginal, right? And like this black reparation shit, honestly. White men were slaves before the black man. Fucking hell, do your history. Go and learn some history. And if you're young and have black skin, wake the fuck up. You really need to wake the fuck up. Oh, God almighty. You have a president out there that cares more about you. See, all the lies are being spread that Trump said all that shit when in fact it was Joe Biden. It was Joe Biden. And it was just so wrong what went on in your country to put a man like Trump through all that he's going through. And I'll tell you now, I hope Trump sues the government for every cent that he has spent defending himself for all his losses, for all the losses that they have caused him. And he should sue for that money back from that government. He really should. And if he doesn't, yeah, that just proves what sort of man he is. An honest man. And if you can't tell Trump is honest, just go back and watch that show that he did on TV, the bloody, the one where you're fired. I forget the name of that one. But yeah, he gave people a chance many times, many times. And yeah, yous are mad if you don't do something about it. Don't vote for the Democratic Party. Like, they're just as bad. The Democratic Party is just as bad as our Liberal Party here in Australia, trust me. I don't even trust the Labor Party here. I vote for another party. I vote for the Cannabis Party now, just to spite the other two. I used to be a member of the Labor Party here, but I've seen the corruption. And I have seen the corruption in the Labor Party. It's one of the reasons I left the Labor Party and stopped voting for them. Because, yeah, it's all over the world. There's corruption all over the world. And trust me, politicians, yeah, most politicians lie all the time. And think about how much money these politicians have made while they've been in government. There's a video out on there where Trump has actually lost money. Why? Because Trump never took a bribe. And Trump never took any money under the table. He spent his own money doing it. Now he's forced to actually ask for help so that he can do it. But Trump, really, mate, I personally think you should win the election. And I, to the rest of the Americans out there, if you don't vote for Trump, you're in trouble. You really are going to be in trouble because Biden is going to send your country downhill, and really is. And just look at that gaffe we're here, that first one that I showed where he's talking about the what, like, supposed to be about something else, and then said, oh yeah, it was supposed to be about Jordan and thing, and he says, oh, Ukraine. This man doesn't know where he is, who he is half the time. He can't even walk off stage sometimes. He's got to look for this. Yeah, he's got to get help. He's following security around instead of them following him because he doesn't know where to go. This woman covers for him left, right and centre. The press have started to realise this. This is why they grill this woman so badly. Because she, as far as I'm concerned, she's one of the biggest liars I've ever met. And you can tell when she's lying. She just rants on. She's been told to say these lies and everything. See, the effect is they want Michelle Obama to be president so Obama can run her. I think that's why she doesn't want to be president. Because she knows her husband will be still running the show. And trust me, he will. He'll still be running the show because it won't be anybody else running your government but Barack Obama. It's who's running your government now, and you need to realise it. The evidence is there. The links to all these videos are going to be at the bottom of this video. And go through. And these will lead you to many other videos. Look at the truth. Look at the truth out there. That all these things lead to one man and one man only. That man, right there. So they're shaking hands with Joe there. But the more you go through it, you can tell. All right, he's making himself out there. See, that's not a president. A president wouldn't stand for that shit. He wouldn't stand. That's a puppet. That is a mentally ill patient who is being used. And yes, I have to say mentally ill. Because he is. You put him before a mentally ill panel, whatever they call them over there. You put him through one of those panels of numerous doctors. It's like when you're here in Australia, right? If you, because like when you go for painkillers and stuff like that here, the pain clinics put you through such psychological test because they want to make sure you're not going to kill yourself. Same sort of thing. He needs to be put through a panel of doctors that will say, okay, this man is not mentally insane. And or this man needs to be left alone, retire him because he has dementia. It's clear. If you've had anybody in your family with dementia, you know for a fact this man has dementia. And everybody's starting to realise it now. But you have a party that is using a patient of dementia to run a country like a puppet. And the proof is there just in these few videos. There is enough proof in these videos that he's not running the country. Barack Obama is. Because look at the attention they're giving to Barack. Look at Joe. That's not a president, folks. Wake the fuck up. Please. Because what happens to America can happen to a lot of Western countries. I.e., you get in the shit because of this man. And that those Italian mocking videos are a good example. And type in Italians mock Joe Biden. Look at that video where he pushes the big button and it just suddenly ends. That's who currently has the finger on the button. I don't think they give him the red button. He's not even allowed to talk. They stop his speeches. Wake the fuck up, America! And I'm talking to every single black voter out there. Got nothing against black people because I'm part fucking black. Yes, I got white in me as well. But many of you do too. So wake the fuck up, for God's sake, before you put the rest of the world in danger, because that's what you're going to do if you let the Democrats in power. A party that stoops to their level of election interference. I can't even say it. It just boggles the mind. Do you know that America is the biggest laughing stock in the world at the moment? They really are. Because of what you're letting them do to Trump. A lot of, like the truckies over there, have realised that he's being railroaded. Many have realised he's being railroaded. Why don't the rest of you go on strike as well and join the truckers? Stock up a bit of food before you do. Oh, people that go on strike over here, we do that. We're smart enough to stock up on a bit of food before we go on strike because we know we're not going to get any wages. So you've got to work out what you really want. Do you want a corrupt government running it? Because at the moment, you have a dictator running it from the background. He didn't want to lose power. That's why they got Joe in. They knew he had a dementia. Even his wife knows he's got dementia. And just look at the poor man. That is a man lost. He's not president. Barack Obama is. Wake up, America. Wake the fuck up. Anyhow, that's it. That's most I'm doing. So have fun, America. I wish you well. Because if you vote for this man or the Democratic Party, you need to actually do something about the Democratic Party. You need to find out who's doing all this stuff. Sorry, that's just my alarm telling me I've got to do something. So I've got to go anyhow. So good luck, America. I hope you make the right decision in 24. Oh, that's right. It is 24, isn't it? So I hope you make the right decision. I really, truly do. Because you're up the creek without a paddle. Because if in November, I think it's November 5th, if you vote for the Democratic Party, you're an absolute fucking idiot. Anyhow, I'm out. I've got to go anyhow. I've got to go and do a job. So see you all later. Bye. Oh, and by the way, I haven't been on because unfortunately I suffered an accident. And you're going to laugh. This is a bit of a laugh for you. Sitting on the dunny seat at the hospital, I went to get my hand checked out. And sitting on the damn toilet seat in a hospital that certainly needed maintenance, broke, spun me around, threw me against the wall, threw me back out. I've been so doped up on drugs, I haven't done anything for the last couple of weeks. So I'm sorry. But yeah, I will be back hopefully this week sometime. I can't promise if I'll be out there on Tuesday, but I will try and get out there on Thursday. As long as the doctor approves me to sort of get back to everything, because at the moment I'm spending most of my time laying down in bed. I'm in that much pain. I felt enough to get up and do this because this needed to be done. So that's where I've been, guys. Anyhow, sorry. I'll hopefully be back this week. Good luck. God bless. Now, also, yeah, where is it? Not that one. Got to find the damn thing. Where is it? There we go. Now, don't forget to like, subscribe. Don't forget to click that little bell, because if you don't click the little bell, you're not going to get notified. Many have come back to me and say, oh, we never get told about the videos. And I said, if you click the little bell, they forget to click the bell. That's why they don't get notified. So, yeah, don't forget to like, subscribe. Yeah, and hopefully, yeah, I'll get back soon. All right, guys, I'll catch you all later. Bye.